So let's take a look at some of those neat little string functions that we saw previously. So I'm going to start off by just simply typing in first name equals Christopher. We'll just get that stored. And then last name equals Harrison. Perfect. Now, like we've already seen, we can concatenate things together by using that plus sign. So if I say print and I say first name, and by the way, a little IntelliSense bit of functionality for you. If you see the word that you want already highlighted, all that you need to do is hit tab and that will complete it out for you. It'll save you a little bit of typing. So if I say first name plus last name, save this, and then I go ahead and run this. Oops, let me, there we go. Make sure I'm in the right spot. You'll notice that it prints out Christopher Harrison. Now, if I update this, let's go ahead and put in our print, and then we'll say hello. First name, a space, and then our last name. And again, I'm using that tab to help me out with the autocomplete. Now what you're going to notice is that it gives us that hello Christopher Harrison with the spaces inside of there. Now if instead of printing it out like that, maybe I wanted to go ahead and bring that in from the user, and let me just comment out the code, so that way it will still be in existence there. I could go ahead and say first name equals input, and we'll say please enter your first name. And then, and actually before I do this, I want you to notice right here that little last name and those little green squigglies, yes, that is the technical term, underneath there, that's Visual Studio Code letting me know, hey, there's something that's not quite right here. If you ever see that, you want to pause, take a look at your code, and see if there's potentially a mistake. In my case, the mistake is that I haven't declared last name yet. Remember, we had it up here, but we've commented it. And remember what Susan taught us earlier, that when you comment out a line of code, that's now not going to run any longer. So let me go ahead and enter in our last name here. And we'll say, please enter your last name. And now, let's go ahead and run this, and we'll see what happens. So it asks me, please enter my first name, Christopher. Please enter my last name, Harrison. Hit enter, and now it tells me, hello, Christopher Harrison. And if we want to go ahead and capitalize everything, we can go ahead and say capitalize and capitalize. Again, we'll save that. And now let's come back and rerun our code. What's my first name? And I'm going to shout it, Christopher. What's my last name? Harrison. And you'll notice the results here that we wind up getting that Christopher Harrison with just the capital C and the capital H, because once again, we've used that capitalize from before. Now, if we want to do things like lower and upper and so forth, all of those are available to us inside of Python. Now, if you want to get in and see some of the other things that you could potentially do with strings, you can take a look at the docs inside of Python. Those are some of the more common ones that you'll find yourself reaching for when you get in and start working with strings inside of Python.